chase the only hard hit ball, or the only ball to get out of the infield for the top three, and Jennings will reach here as Mason could not reel in the off-target throw from Muffley. And the tying run is aboard, and Jocelyn Alo, the go-ahead with a bat in her hand.
Muffley's just got to throw this off of her front foot. She makes this play all the time. Her momentum takes the throw up the line. Nothing Mason can do. E6.
Ball.
This is the game right here. You just feel it. And not that Oklahoma can't score in the top of the seventh when they have more at-bats, but this is who they want up to bat when they want them.
Ball.
Season record.
She's one of the best for a reason. This is not a bad pitch. A lot of times we're looking at mistakes made by a pitcher. This is a drop ball outside, and Jocelyn Alo not only gets to it, she crushes it. That is such a hard pitch to be able to hit, let alone drive. The emotion from Jocelyn Alo.
A home run every 5.4 at-bats. She was a couple ABs late, but I don't think the Sooners will mind. Since she hit her last one earlier in the World Series. And a 3-2 Oklahoma lead.
Ball.
Off speed to Kinzie Hansen, 1-1. They got every record imaginable. Best batting average in a season. Slug, most home runs, most runs scored. And the best lineup that we've ever seen has taken the lead in game two, trying to tie up the champ series. Hansen at first.
And it's that third time through the lineup where the adjustments really start to come through for Oklahoma.
I've never heard it louder here.
Never been 13,000 here before.
Upper deck.
With a new capacity. And as you would imagine in OKC, most of the fannies in the seats belong to Sooner fans. And there aren't many fannies in those seats right now, on their feet. Football coach.
Of course.
A selfie.
Where else would you want to be in this state? Bring your kids. Looks like he's got his baby girls.
We set it up earlier in the ball game. The later they go, the more pitches they see from the starter the better they get at the plate. And the third time through, Jocelyn Alo crushes a two-run home run to right center.
That's huge right there. I mean, honestly, I can't imagine Catherine Sandercock has ever had that loud of a crowd, that much emotion. Lonnie Alameda called timeout. This place got louder. She comes back and throws a strike. Smitty, you know how hard that can be.
Riley Boone, your pinch runner. Hanson can re-enter. 0-1 to Nicole Mendez.
Yeah, it's all about focus and continuing to work with your catcher.
Two misses away.
What I still can't get over this. We haven't had fans in the stands for how long like this at a college event. This is the first time we've had this many. And to have it be in a game like this, this is a pretty special, it's a pretty special moment.
Mendez, and that will get through. Boone will hold at second. Two on and still nobody out. And it's the local fan favorite, Donahue, coming up. Third hit of the inning for the Sooners with Mendez aboard.
And I know Alo had the big home run, but it's still the ground balls. They're now just finding holes. I mean, really, Sandercock's getting the results she wants. Weaker ground balls, finding spots that can get through the infield.
For both these teams, they've stressed throughout the tournament the personal accolades, the numbers don't matter. It's all about doing stuff for the team. Survive, advance. Remember the home run by Jocelyn Alo in the semifinals when the game was in hand. She sent one out, and the trot around the bases was pretty matter of fact. She knew she had more business to tend to. And what a difference today that it's a go-ahead home run in an elimination game. Hello.
The Shaka to her home state of Hawaii. The emotion and passion.
Talking with G. Juarez, how about the job that G has done? I thought that the last two innings Florida State had a lead up on. Couldn't do anything. G shut him down. That's momentum, right? You're building for the opportunity for the offense to do their job, and they have just come out here and exploded in this top of the sixth.
On base. Missed it away. Check in with Holly Rowe.
Well, guys, Jocelyn Alo has sacrificed a ton to be here in this moment. She and her dad, Levi, would save up $10,000 each summer, come from Honolulu and come here to the U.S., get a one-bedroom apartment so she could play travel ball all summer long. There were long nights, long drives. Their family sacrificed so much. But here she is with an opportunity for a championship, and she said it's all worth it.
Well, Holly, part of that pressure she put on herself was asking herself, have I earned the amount of money that my parents spent on all the travel, all the time? I need to make sure that I'm paying them back with my performance. And she said she put that pressure on herself early, and it wasn't until her freshman year at Oklahoma she kind of looked at herself, looked at her dad, and said, I've done it. It's been worth all the money and time.
Score. still nobody out.
Starting to really take advantage of the pitch low in the zone, make that adjustment.
This is the adjustments. As you see Catherine Sandercock come out of this game, because Oklahoma has figured out how to hit her.
Things are heating up in Oklahoma City. The Sooners force the pitching change with the 4-2 lead. Oklahoma City Hall of Fame Stadium. A must-win game for Oklahoma to force game three of our championship series here tomorrow afternoon. And the pitching change to Kalen Arnold, senior from Maryville, Tennessee.
Ball.
Jada Coleman will step in. Three runs in the inning. The towering home run from Jocelyn Alo. The RBI single, Mackenzie Donahue. Nobody out. They have chased the starter, Catherine Sandercock. In an inning that all started with a defensive error. And as Patty Gasso likes to say, with this lineup so strong from top to bottom, things get hot real fast. And we have seen just that. Here in the sixth, and it's getting hotter. Mendez will score.
Change up on the outside corner that Coleman just waits on. Let it travel deep in the strike zone. And the Sooners really doing a good job of seeing pitches, letting them travel, and then barreling them up here late in the game with the dirt, the gladiator.
The gladiator is
on the team. I believe they are at this point here in the arena. In-house gladiators.
He's got a Sooner shield there. One pitch to Lyons, and she will drop down the bunt. Moves a couple 60 feet closer to home.
It's crazy. All these runs that have scored, the momentum of this inning, the huge hits. There were no outs, and so still now getting to the bottom of this lineup, playing small ball, sacrificing runners over.
Janet Johns grounded out in the fifth, her first at bat, a home run ball in the third.
Ball.
Run, sixth inning, two more in scoring position.
Ball.
Five hits in the inning.
Ball.
Of this World Series for Arnold. Second in relief, also has a couple of starts. Nine innings of work, has given up two home runs. second year in the program after transferring in from Tennessee, where she was an SEC Freshman of the Year. And the bases are loaded for Lindsey Elam. She's one of the double-digit home run hitters in this lineup. Hit a couple in the Big 12 tournament. Hit a couple in the regionals. JMU here on Thursday, came back with a one-rule win. Beat by Florida State last night. And looking to respond in kind after an 8-4 loss. They have backed up their defeats this year big time. Florida State fans trying to help the defense at Arnold right now.
How about the riches for Patty Gasso? So Elam does not start. She comes off the bench. She's a 350-plus hitter. She's got double-digit home runs. I mean, she didn't even start today's game, and that's who's coming off the bench. That's just how good and how much depth there is on this Oklahoma team.
Oh, in the dirt. Good block by Shelnut. Holy cow, part of that softball fan is missing. Been a few of those moments throughout this Women's College World Series. Odyssey Alexander and JMU are getting all the way to the national semifinals. The last games for legendary head coach Mike Candrea on these fields before he announced his retirement after the Wildcats returned to Tucson.
The 10 seed battling with the 1 seed, both sides coming out of the loser's bracket to make it to the Champ Series.
Final game for Lou Harris Champer as well, with the Georgia Bulldogs on this field. The pop up, two down, 25 years in the coaching ranks for Lou. And the more memories to come, either tonight for Florida State or a carryover into tomorrow for Oklahoma. Started out the inning reaching on an error and then trotting home in front of Jocelyn Alo on the home run. They've come all the way back around. And that one with Harding coming on makes the catch. That will end the inning with four on the board and a lead for OU.
The National Player of the Year for a reason, Jocelyn Alo with another one, the biggest one to put her Sooners up.